Hello guys, in today's video I'll be talking about two very interesting topics, which is trading and investing, and I'll be explaining you the difference between the two. Generally people are very much confused and they think trading and investment both are the same concepts, though they are not. They are very different, but the only similarity is doing trading as well as doing investing, you look to make money, you look to make profits. That's the only similarity between the two. And so first of all, I'll explain you, trading is nothing when you make money in between the price fluctuations, and it's mainly to do with buying and selling, right? Or it could be vice versa. In certain markets you can sell also and then you can close your trades. Basically it's about making small profits, taking an entry, and let's say you are at a current price of 100 rupees, okay, and you expect the prices to go up to 200. So then that's the time you take a buy at 100, and as and when market reaches at 200 and you book your profits and come out. That's trading. Investing is all about buying and holding. So you buy a certain stock, let's say at a very low price, and you expect it to grow over a period of time, let's say around 2 years, 5 years, and you compound your profits over a period of time. This mainly investing is for wealth creation, or you can say for long-term profits. And trading is all about small profits, wherein, but trading also is all about making consistent growth of your equity. So if you have to both, like I said, the only similarity is both, in both the concepts we are looking to make money, but the way of making money is different. So in trading, generally people take trading as a profession also, like I also have trading as a profession, wherein I look for monthly growth. I look for making a certain percentage on a monthly basis. So with trading, you can have your income on a consistent level, and that's where you can call yourself as a professional trader. Whereas investing amount is more to do with for emergencies or for future, if you need any money, or for future emergencies, or for future requirements, or when you are old and you need money. So you do with that perspective that you want to save some income for your old age basically, or maybe for your kids' marriages and all those things. So you invest a certain amount of money, and also you look at that there is lesser risk in investments. Generally there is lesser risk, and in trading there is higher risk, because trading you try to capture in between the price fluctuations. So at times you go against the direction, which means you go against the trend also to make money. But investing is all about going with the trend, going with the direction. Like I said, if something is looking bullish, you will take a buy and just hold on. So I'll be explaining you trading and investments both using technical analysis. Though generally it's a saying that for investments you should have fundamental knowledge, and for trading you should have technical analysis knowledge. Though yeah, that's true to an extent, but also for investing, you can do investing through technical analysis also, which simply means you can go to higher time frames and you can check your charts and accordingly enter at better prices. In fact, rather entering it always, there's a perspective that when the market makes all-time high, it's or a 52-week high or something like this, that's when we look to buy at those prices, which means that's the highest price. Though, but eventually we end up making money because we are on the right side of the direction. So if investors also have technical analysis knowledge, they can benefit a lot of it. So basically fundamental analysis, I'm not denying, is not does not work or something like that. If you have a knowledge about both technicals and fundamentals, they work really well. That's the best situation to be in. But honestly speaking, fundamentals is not everyone's cup of tea. Generally, there's a misconception that going through the news channel or reading the newspaper or getting the tips is fundamental analysis. It's not. It's actually a very deep analysis which you have to self-analyze and interpret a data and accordingly figure out what's going to happen in near future. And for that, you need to be an analyst. You need to have those analysis skill, and you need to take out proper time and invest proper invest proper amount of time and effort to derive to a conclusion. It cannot be copied from anywhere. So that's the fundamental analysis. Generally, people just go through the news and buy a stock and say that I am buying using fundamental analysis. That's completely wrong. It's a very detailed analysis, basically. That way, if you have some knowledge of technicals, then it gives you even a higher edge. Like, for example, I'll explain you on charts. This is Reliance Industries charts. And let's say fundamentally you're not much aware. It is for those people who have fundamental knowledge. Definitely, if you have technical, you are at a very good space. But in case, let's say you don't have fundamental knowledge much, but still you want to invest for a long period of time, you can always use technical analysis. So I'll explain. This is a TradingView platform. And this is a monthly chart. Because you are looking to invest, so we have chosen a higher time frame. We can analyze on monthly as well as weekly also. So there's a monthly chart. If you see, Reliance Industries has been going up, and it's almost at a price of 1340, and it has made a high of at around, it's almost near the high is what we can say. So for these, I'll explain you how technical traders would have got better entries than fundamental traders also. Basically, investors is what we can use the word. So if you have a little technical knowledge and a little knowledge about support and resistance, you can clearly see a very strong support here, right? So this is the price where we would be as technical analysis traders. We can look to enter at these prices. And also another thing is, when we are looking to invest, we look to enter for a trend. We look to enter for a direction. We don't want to get stuck in between the consolidation. So if you have charts in front of you, you can always draw this support come resistance line, which initially was a support, became a resistance. And as and when this broke out, if you see, it broke out with a proper bullish body dominating candle. As and when it broke out, it clearly indicated for buy. So instead of getting stuck here, some people would take a buy, and market is just sideways for a long period of time. If you see, from 2010 till 2017, market was in a sideways. So there was no point holding the stock at that point of time. But as and when if you have technical knowledge, if you didn't have much fundamental knowledge about it, then you could have seen this breakout. And as and when you saw the candle closing above this area, which is a very strong resistance, we could have taken a buy here and then held on our trade, which is in a trend, which is in a bullish direction just now. So that way, technical analysis always gives you an edge when it comes to entering in the market. So what basically happens, if you see here as well, especially being fundamental traders, people end up entering at high prices like these or prices like these. But being a technical analysis trader, you get entries at a dip, which we call it as a pullback. So I'll show you the same chart using a weekly time frame. I'll give you a good analysis, a deeper analysis of this. We'll zoom out a chart a little bit. So the same trend line follows here as well. So I'll speak about further. Let's say the bullish movement happens here. So let's talk about this movement, how you can average, keep averaging your positions. Like, for example, let's say, we can clearly, being a technical trader, whosoever knows about support and resistance, they can clearly see this as a very strong support and resistance area, right? There's a very strong support. Now next, if you remember in my previous video itself, I spoke about parallel angles, right? Drawing trend lines. So I'll just do that same thing what I spoke in the previous video. See, so this is market initially was a support, became a resistance, again a support. If I clone it again, see here, So this is clearly giving you the scenario for the current aspect also. So basically it's telling you that market can come, if it comes down from here, these are your entry prices. You can enter to buy here. If market breaks out above this area again, you can enter to buy here again at the pullback. So what investors, basically fundamental analysis people do, they enter at these prices, but we enter at these pullback prices. Again, if we clone this particular, so see, market is always moving technically, respecting your support and resistance all the time. If you can see, all I am doing just drawing the trend lines on the same angle, right? And if you have a confusion how I am doing this, you can always go back to my previous video and I've spoken in detail about this. So all I'm trying to say in this video is there's no doubt if you are fundamentally aware, that definitely gives you a upper hand. But if you are technically aware also, it definitely gives you best possible entries. So being a fundamental trader is you enter at these prices to buy. High prices to buy, but as technical traders we always enter at these prices, which are pullback prices. In fact, investors keep on averaging it, but we as traders, we enter for a buy here, we come out here, we again enter for a buy here, we come out here. So we try. So that's the difference between trading and investing. People keep on adding. So like I said, my very first definition, trading is buying and selling. So we buy here, we sell here, we again buy here, we sell here. But investing is all about keep buying and holding. So you buy here once, you buy here once, you buy here once again, and keep on buying with the trend. So I hope the video was helpful and you got a deep insight about how important technical analysis is. And if you guys have no knowledge about technical analysis, we are there to help you. You can always contact us, you can visit our website, and you can always attend a free live trading session which we conduct every month end. In fact, today is one of the last, this month end session is today also. So if you want, you can always contact us and register yourself to have deeper insights regarding technical analysis. I hope the video was helpful. We'll keep posting such videos to give you deeper insights about trading and making money. Thank you guys. Have a good trading week.